seated and come to order.
Sure. I like those one-word opinions. Sure. We're going to be at ease till 9:15, so if anybody wants to wander around, you can do it. We're not going to be starting again till 10:15, I'm sorry. 10:15.
I took her on a tour of the jail. My mom wouldn't even look into the women's housing unit because she was ashamed.
Sorry, Susan.
It's all right. Of course, I could scoot.
But I'm sure he needed it. It's probably his brothers and everybody else.
Her weapon of choice was warm travel tracks. When she didn't hit you the flat side, she did side.
Oh, come on. I believe he stays waking, I think.
He does. Like I said, that's what I got when I was training him. I was like,
that's very sensitive. Susie, if you're on both shifts tomorrow, you're going to enjoy the festival.
Well, strange.
Yeah,
you take the rain.
You're going to see your day. It's just one of us.
Whoever's next to me, I see much of my stuff. It's gotten as I can't get that long without the bathroom.
I get that.
Yeah.
Sure.
Especially with that very good.
Okay. Somebody want to go out and get the lawyers, and we're going to meet back here.
I'll go that way.
Yeah, if you can tell the lawyers. Ms. Anderson, let you and I go back this way.
I got to go down to 2D anyway.
All right. Send them back to the conference room, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Conference rooms, and it's a mediator. I mean, she's got both of them, and the probation's in the other one.
Hmm.
I don't know where they went.
You want me to try to call them yourself?
Would you please, sir?
Yeah, I don't know where they went.
They might have gone out for Danishes and
coffee. They could have went down to the...
They better bring some back.
Before everybody, they didn't tell us.
Yeah. This is down. 3-foot length of PCV piping. And some duct tape. And I'll put that lever out a little bit further on the camera. It's easier to move. Plus, you can take it off when you're moving, packing up. I learned that when I used to film little kids playing soccer. Yeah, you need that camera a lot.
Depends where your subject is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, wildest thing I saw was when they were filming the new magistrate court instructional video. Defendants. they have the camera, but the boom on this thing is like, God, it had to have been at least a 15-foot span. And they stacked, they were using workout weights as a counterweight. So when they wanted that camera to raise up a little bit, all you had to do was just barely push with your hands and then bring it up and just ease it down. It's just wild, the setup for that. I think a lot of things, it'd just be a static camera.
They're on the way back.
Thank you, sir.
Great. Yeah, apparently they had to go a little further down the hall for rooms.
where you were.
It's okay.
And they're back in the conference.
They are?
Yes.
Do I need a pass to get in there?
Just go through the doorway and knock on the door, they'll let you in.
Okay.
Remain seated and come to work.
Starts breaking up when I'm finally getting close to 316.
Yeah. It starts to kind of ease up. I've made that trip 1,000 times. Well, from over in Cobb, you know, a lot more in Cobb. And I live in the Sugar Hill, so I have to go up 85 over to 285, up 75, and then, God forbid, I get out of court at 3 or 4 o'clock in Cobb County, then I got to come down 75, across 285, down 85. Like you said, it's a nightmare. Jimmy Carter and Beaver Grove and all that. Then it starts to kind of break up at 316.
I bet you know from Cobb, going back to your home or your law office,
yeah.
The routine, I've learned that if I can get out of Atlanta, and leave Atlanta about 3:15,
yeah.
3:30 at the latest, it's not so bad, but after that it's going to be bumper to bumper.
True, words are never spoken. I don't know that route as well around that time, but I can tell you, if I leave Sugar Hill, if I have to go downtown, I live up in Sugar Hill, so I just get on 85 and just come downtown. There's about a 10-minute window around 7 to 7:15. If you get out between 7 and 7:15, your trip downtown's 35 minutes or so. If you leave 1 minute after 7:15, it changes the whole complexion of your travel. I don't know if everybody just leave it at the same time, but if you miss that little 15-minute window, you're looking at sometimes an hour and 15 minutes as opposed to 35 minutes. A 5-minute delay is not a 5-minute delay. A 5-minute delay of you getting out of your house by 7:15 is a 45-minute add-on to the trip or whatever. It's crazy how the traffic works like that. And it was kind of crazy traffic, and I couldn't.
I'm sure Mr. Powell, go ahead.
Is he back?
No. I was telling any of the witnesses, I'm sure Mr. Powell will come back in soon, but he's getting some things done. If you're a witness in this case, Mr. Powell may want to talk to you, but we're going to excuse you to 1 o'clock. Now, it may be that you don't have to come back. It may be that you will, so you'll have to get in touch with him. But the more I think about it, you better wait till Mr. Powell tells you that.
And then it was crazy traffic, so I couldn't get back over into the regular lane. And this is when they got the cameras for the beach pass and all that stuff. I was just waiting to get something, and then they all say it. Because I finally got over.
So there's a cameraman, a guy, taking a picture of
it. I know, I haven't gotten anything, but I thought to myself, you know,
I'm
at the village. The first time I could safely get back out that lane was, cameras take pictures of
the
LPCRB.
That's amazing. Whether you've got a passenger.
Take care.
I didn't volunteer, but they needed somebody that I had time for.
I changed my office address.
Oh, okay.
So, it's just a stone's throw from.
I got you.
Down the street.
You and her building? You and her old office?
Yeah.
You and her old office?
Just this weekend.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. She's
big money.
Yeah, me and her.
Yeah, when you go on, I did.
You come see my new office.
Press that button.
Where?
Just me. I wouldn't have my office. But this is me.
No, it's just you.
That's so good. South Carolina.
No,
that's
all close.
I mean, too many.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they all know how to use them. They're all trained.
Yeah,
they're all
trained. I'm a Yankee. But I'm
So
you want to go ahead and excuse your folks for 1 o'clock?
Yes, sir. You guys, you guys get printed?
Not yet.
Okay.
We're trying.
Okay.
Judge said you have to excuse them.
You, Mr. Powell. Again, your name, Mr.
McClurg.
McClurg, yeah. Y'all come up here just a minute.
Yes, sir.
Come close to me. This is the order that I would propose if we arrive at all this. For Mr. Anderson's benefit, the key words in that whole thing are with prejudice. If it's dismissed with prejudice, that means nobody can bring the argument ready for that order. Without prejudice, that means they can be brought in. With prejudice means they can be brought in.
Judge, I need to get back.
Thank you.
Get back.
I feel like I'm somebody.
I'll be right back. Okay. You want me to get that typed up too, Judge?
Well, I wanted to put it at the end of the release.
Okay.
So
just put this on at the end.
Yeah, but the release hasn't been, I hadn't done it.
I was just going.
I don't know about that. You know, just like this guy right here.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
He is the best officer in the community. And if you don't try to do the best you can, we all got limitations, you understand? And I make a lot of mistakes. But if you don't try to do the best you can, in my opinion, we're just broken. So I try to do the best I can. That's all you can ask of me.
Well, I've said for years, I'll apologize if I make a mistake. I'm human. Sometimes I've said I wish elected officials would admit when they make a mistake, but I tell people I'm human, and I do make mistakes. I have apologized several times. We all make because we're human.
But we try to do the best we can.
Yeah, let me go ahead and fill them. I think they've gotten some of the issues clear, but we'll just talk about it back to one client. So, the document is signed.
That's all we can do.
I'm
just saying. Oh.
Oh, here's your card, kid.
Oh, yeah.
All right, now it's my turn.
I was thinking about this as I'm lugging all this equipment in. They come in with a pad,
right,
paper, and a pencil,
right?
I wonder which they look at me, because she has lost her mind.
I can't even begin to think how that would go. It just seems so shorthand. There you go. Exactly.
Boom mic. I record by boom mic.
Okay, where did everybody go?
I am not sure. You want me to go and get them?
One, two, three. We need to get three copies, photocopies of this.
I can do that.
Can you do that?
Yeah.
What? Is there anything you can't do now?
I'm sure there is.
That's the least I can contribute. All right, Mr. Anderson. Where is Mr.?
Excuse me. Can you go find them?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're not going to let you sit down and rest. Okay, let's go on back there.
Do you need Mr. Trevor to come?
Yeah.
about as bad as a Catholic church. Up, down, hill. Thousand scrape, you know. I can say I'm Catholic, so I can.
Bring your community wine.
Yeah, bingo, wine, all kind of stuff. Catholics, we love it, so. They weren't gonna give you the blood and body. Yeah, I didn't like that either. It's like, look, I mean, come on. We're on the same team.
Yeah, sure.
Right, you wear maroon, we wear gold, whatever, we're on the same team.
Yeah, I was sort of a little ticked off at that.
Absolutely.
Thank you. How do you know what to record? Do you record anything? I mean,
there's nothing.
She listens for more on the record. Let's go on the record.
A lot of doors opening and closing, like door number one, door number two, door number three. Mm-hmm.
So far, it's all the backroom negotiations, right?
Keeps you hot. We're doing a lot of work back there, which is good.
Oh, I'm sure.
I've seen some stuff come through there. Remain seated and come to order.
Yeah. My wife doesn't get up when I come in the room. My children never did either. I know how to get to everybody. I just tell them, nobody's leaving. We're not going to eat lunch. We're not going to have a bathroom break. We're not going to do anything to get this matter resolved. You'd be surprised how persuasive that is.
It's motivational, sir.
Yes.
I know the pastor. I mean, I know my pastor.
If you go to the latest, I stayed one time for a verdict.
Oh, yeah. See,
2 a.m. I'm going to need to know. They were coming up on an everyday weekend. The jury did not want to come back on Saturday. Staying until Saturday, technically.
Well, I would give them the option as to what they wanted to do.
Yeah, see the password. Yes.
I normally, as far as the trial is concerned, I don't know as much as five.
Servers, mail, dot, snail.
You get so many people that have family obligations. But on verdicts, if they want to go, we go.
Yeah. Username, I've got a username. Yeah, whatever your city is. That was pretty every time there's a question. Do you have a close card of user?
I bet you they want to watch that hour 45-minute video of yours. I bet you.
All right, you tell me when you're ready, Mr. Anderson. I'm not. not putting any time limit on you. Whenever you get ready, you tell me. Your clients can't read, but that's from what you said.
I think they can.
So. Your Honor, I'd like to keep that with it if you're it, when I get your age, because too many times my wife says I'm sarcastic or I'll say something facetious. But to me, it's just being witty like that. I like that.
Well, my wife says I'm half witty.
Oh, I hope she didn't say half wit.
I think that's what she means.
Gotta hit the specs.
Oh, yeah.
Chief judges are now female judges.
Yeah.
Connor for Superior, you got South for State, and you got England for Magistrate.
Mr. Connor's been around here long enough, you haven't had.
She sure has. You'll start to see more pastel colors in the roads and all that stuff. That's great. No. I don't know, you might look good in a chartreuse or something like that. Mm-hmm. It's mauve color.
Not my color. I would try it. you all know Judge McWhorter, Pam McWhorter from down around Winder. In that area?
I'm not familiar with that.
Okay. Well, he wears a royal blue robe. And he'll tell you the reason he does that, is because, and he's the only one in the state of Georgia who wears one. The reason he does that is that judges always wore royal blue robes until the death of one of the queens in England, and out of respect, they wore black for her death, but then they just continued on wearing black, and then they went back to the royal blue. But he's researched it. Now, with me, I don't wear a robe except when his jury is present, and I'll tell you why. I was on the Judicial Qualifications Commission for 8 years, and the biggest complaint that the lay people had was that judges. They thought because they put a robe on, they were somebody special. But I didn't want to. I might think I'm special, but it's not because I am wearing a robe, see?
We
okay?
I think we're good, Judge.
Okay, well, let him finish first.
Plus royal blue. Fire road company.
Yeah.
I don't have a choice. easier though.
No, Jordan, you're not like I am. I'm pretty regimented when I'm on park. I have suits, right?
I still do most of them.
I always take from the left, put back on the left.
You always rotate?
And 15th of October, I start wearing long sleeve shirts. 15th of April, I wear short sleeve shirts. That's way easier.
I call my duty t-shirts, they're all navy blue.
Yes, sir, if we could get these changes agreed to, we'll be right there.
Let me see. Y'all can come on up here somewhere. Get everybody signed it too. All right, let's go back in the room.
Share words in the courtroom, guys. We'll just wait for the battle to happen when the judge is on the bench.
Thank you, sir.
That way everybody's content.
You just don't know how evil they are.
Thank you.
subject legal action against public participation, a slap. Will not have my speech killed. I'm trying to get away from your stain.
Let's try to minimize the poking.
Yeah, just
close to lunchtime when I'm hungry. I get passion to.
Where's Miss Anderson?
He stepped out in the hallway, sir.
Okay.
You like me to call him back in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ho, ho, ho. Sit together. There you go. Just come over here and sit with me, Mr. Ash.
Okay. My sheet's over here.
That's right. I got your paper here.
Oh, okay. Thank you, sir.
I got your paper.
They're minor changes.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, this is loaded in, isn't it? I tried to pull it.
I did too. And it doesn't work.
It won't work.
They will greet everything you got except this. You understand they got to satisfy their clients too. If they leave this part in, they'll greet everything else you got.
You see that?
You want your glasses?
I'll take
your glasses.
She has nothing else to shoot at.
No. They want this in, but they agree to all your other changes except that one.
Thank you, sir.
There you go again.
This is Mendoza. Here we go.
Okay, see,
Mr. Anderson.
Thank you, sir.
They're going to talk it over, but I think we're on the right track. Now, you know what I really hurt everybody? If I had this guy getting a real big, juicy hamburger, and I sit up here and eat it, let you all smell it. Well, it's the best job in the world. I still think. My biggest concern right now is who is going to get this file back to the clerk's office.
We'll take care of it, sir. We'll take care of it.
I'm going to have something else a little bit.
Yes, sir.
Hopefully.
I guess the only glitch would be if their client said no to it.
I don't even speak in those terms.
That's one of my failings. I gotta quit doing this what if all the time. My wife tells me, she says, wait till it happens.
That's right. Instead of worrying about city problems, you need to start worrying about your solving your problems.
That's right. Well, I was sharing with you a moment ago. I was telling him that I said last year, I'm retiring, and Miss Tisdale was there at the state ethics hearing. I told Lori Gary, WSB, and all of them, Dale Russell, I said, I am through. I'm going to take care of my health. And then this thing was filed 12 days later.
Yeah, well, you got to take care of yourself.
Yeah, I'm going to focus on my health.
And you got to do it, you know, as much for yourself, but also for your wife. I'm sure she has grown to depend on you a good bit.
She has, in fact.
Just like you depend on her. No, excuse me just a minute. I got a telephone call. You going to take my phone away?
No, sir. You come right in.
Hello.
Okay.
Yeah. Hello. Well, fortunately, I didn't get to it in time. Ain't no water in Amarillo, Texas. There's not any water anywhere. And she got up the very first time she
ever. I think we're ready to go, Judge.
All right.
You want to
sign?
We don't have it typed up. You want us to fix it?
Oh, yeah, you
want
to fix it.
And, okay.
Hey, Tony,
okay.
Where's your thumb drive?
It's
the right one. It's going to be on the thumb drive. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, y'all can, but you take your time because I've already ordered a hamburger.
Okay. Can I borrow your badge just to get back to you?
And I'm upstairs in that common room on one of the benches, and I've got a desk in there. And when I have an order to write, I just go up there. And just be by myself. And I don't write it out in the hand. I just finished preparing just an 8-page order in a case that's single space. How many pages that would be in double space? I thought about double spacing, but then I would have had to pay more postage, so I decided, because I got to pay that out of my pocket, so I decided to single space it. I
wouldn't have been able to probably
restoration. But it's not new to do that. Hungry yet?
You're hungry, Judge.
Yes, sir.
unfortunately, this is moving out so close with my daughter. I wouldn't have it any other way.
Sorry. I was waiting for you.
It's like the president, you know, give me another pen.
There you go.
I don't know where these guys are going to be. You know, what is amazing to me, in Stevens County, they are no longer teaching their children to
cursive
writing.
It's gone.
That's right.
That's like one of my pet peeves. I talk to people about, like, you know, they're not teaching your kid how to write in cursive. I mean, I don't know how you sign your name anymore and
you
those
print.
Types of, yeah. It's absurd.
I mean, I haven't figured out why. I always like to understand why.
I'm sure that
like what I do, but you're entitled to understand why I do what I did.
They'd have some long explanation, Judge. They would go on, it would just be mind-numbing, some, you know. There's no real good explanation for it.
Of course, you understand my cursive writing is not very good, but still.
I still can't figure out why school teachers have to take money out of their own pocket and buy school supplies. Our school teachers have to take money out of their own pocket and buy school supplies.
I mean,
that's embarrassing. I'm embarrassed by that. Somehow,
there's something wrong with that.
Of course there is.
Writing in cursive teaches you to be creative and individual.
Absolutely. Your own style. That's right.
You're taking that out of the
dawn.
You want to process the only way individual to be the same.
If I have a child in the school system, then they're not teaching in cursive. That means to me, that's base.
No.
That's the first time I even rubbed his cheeks. Y'all don't remember, you had to do these circles?
Oh, yeah.
And I was terrible at doing those circles like this. And so I do the circle, then I go back and go like this.
I would hate to think of what that looked like.
Not a cheek to it.
I would never expect that. But I have a friend with bullets.
They've already signed it. You want to go look at it one last time, and then you can sign it if you want.
Yeah, I put the copy right there.
My copy.
Okay, there it is. Here it is, right here. That's not it.
I gave him a copy here.
Yeah, you got a copy. Same thing I got. That's the same thing.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, don't tell me you need your glasses. Why don't you just leave them on? That's what I do.
I should.
You know, when I had cataract surgery, they wanted to put implants in there, you know, so you don't have to wear glasses anymore. I've worn glasses since I was 20 years old. I got trifocals, and I'd be lost without them.
That's what I need to do, is get bifocals.
No, I got trifocals.
Because this is just for reading.
My mom did that, had the cataract surgery, and put lenses in both eyes. She says it's great.
Yeah, I'm sure it is, but I like them. I'm comfortable with my glasses.
I had LASIK surgery years ago. Best money I ever spent. It's fantastic. And apparently, I'm getting a little older. I'm 44.
I really appreciate it.
Yeah,
he's 44 too.
Yeah, I'm about ready to fall over right now.
But can I help you?
Yeah. But I noticed since about 42, I do need close-up stuff. I can't kind of do this. But my long range is fantastic. guess you can get it done again. You're supposed to get it done, or you can't get it done.
That's the evil of youth. You just think you're on top of the world.
Because if that, there is a fall.
It's going to happen.
It changes one more time. So I might get it kind of tuned up.
But you don't splat as hard when you're younger.
Get older, you just kind of hit it.
Don't bounce.
Highway signs were saying, and now it's just crystal clear.
Oh, I haven't. I'm bad about sayings. I have a new saying. You're never old until you quit.
That's true.
And I am trying not to quit.
She said, see, I can't even read that. I looked over and went, there you go.
She couldn't even tell because I was saying.
So your anniversary is Monday. 60 years.
That's right. It'd be 59, wouldn't it? I was admitted second Monday in October 1954. I start my 60. 60 years to be
Yeah. Yeah.
Go the other way, you have to learn more.
Yeah.
And I cannot imagine anything more fulfilling, more exciting, more interesting, more challenging. Isn't everything that you can think of? No question about that. And you know, my mother, when I told her I was going to law school, my mother cried. She wanted me to be a minister.
Completely.
I'm not good enough to be a minister. Okay, let me have the rest of it, and I'll sign it. I got my pen, even though it still has some ink.
Is this yours?
It is mine.
Thank you.
Okay, sign. Now I'm going to make speech.
I'm dying to type something down.
Here's your big chance.
I know there have been a lot of feelings in this thing from everybody's side. But you have been, if we let feelings govern our lives, we're going to have too many highs and too many lows. We need to have reason enter into what we do. I honestly believe that you all have allowed reason to come into this case. I think when you get home, you're going to understand that what you did was the right thing. Especially Mr. Anderson, you've got certainly your wife to worry about, and your health is not good, and you don't need something like this hanging around. And I think you have allowed reason to enter into what you have done today, and I appreciate that very much. And I appreciate also the other side too, because I he thinks he's right. You all think you're right. Who's right? I don't know whether you look at this one of these days. Plato has a book of letters. He writes letters. The very first letter he wrote, he posed the question, what is justice? And he writes for 14 pages in his book. And at the end, he makes this statement, and I'm quoting, I conclude that I know not what justice is. Justice means different things to different people. But when you allow reason to come in, you can see that there are two sides. Often. Most of the time there are two sides. You can come up with a resolution such as you all have done today. In child custody cases, I have the mother and her family, the father and his family. And they take the witness stand and they lie. And I know they're lying. But they don't think it's wrong, because they think that their side is the right side to have custody of these children, so they're justified in telling whatever they want to tell in order that they can convince the judge to award the child, custody of the child one side or the other. And I understand that, and I don't think badly of them. Because people do what they do. And most of the time, if we really understood their motives behind what they do, we would be a whole lot more understanding. So again, thank you all. Now, who is going to take responsibility to get this clerk's file and this order to the clerk?
I'll be glad to, Your Honor.
Go home and sin no more.
Have a safe trip home.
And you do too, and I have your address, and I will send you that sermon.
Thank you. I look forward to getting it in the mail and reading it.
Good.
Thank you, Your Honor, for allowing me to.
Okay.
Let's go home.
Have a safe trip.
Thank you, Judge. Good night.
Thank you. See y'all later.
Y'all are really good.
Thanks, Tony.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
Call me if I help you.
Go in or out.
I'm going in. Thank you.
What happened?
It's completed.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
Take care, folks.
So this gentleman, please.
This gentleman. Everything signed off.
I don't think I've met you, young lady. What's your name?
My name is Nydia Tisdale. Nydia Tisdale. I'm independent. I have a blog called The About Forsyth Forum.
Oh, do you?
And I film public meetings and hearings, and I post them on YouTube, and then I link to them in my blog.
Well, Nydia, that's nice. I noticed you were very observant today. Do you have a card?
Unfortunately, I don't, but do you have one? And I'll send you a link to the video when it's on.
What's the link?
It's about Forsyth.
About Forsyth?
Yes.
Okay.
Like Forsyth.
You know we're not Forsyth.
Yes. We are Gwinnett communities.
Good.
Okay.
Well, so nice meeting you, lady.
All right.
Excuse me, your name, sir?
It's Brendo Simpson. I'm the last coroner of Gwinnett County.
Oh, very good.
I was the last coroner judge. This was the former mayor of the town.
Y'all have a nice day.
Years.
Take care, sir.
Enjoy your weekend. Okay.
Well, you're a very lovely young lady. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very pleasure. See you, Sheriff.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to meet you. And old judge headed back to court?
Yes, he is.
He's one more good guy. What's your name, young lady?